Hi, I'm glad you came back. Last episode, we saw that waveform charts accumulate data points and waveform graphs do not. Now, let's focus on some permutations on using waveform charts and graphs, like displaying multiple plots and changing our timing. A common thing to want to be able to do is to display multiple plots. Maybe they're coming from different sensors, maybe a temperature and a pressure sensor. So how do I get both of those on the same chart? Well, our context help is valuable in this case. I'll hit Control H, hover over my waveform chart, and I have a little table here telling me what data to wire in and then what the result is on the chart. As we've already seen, if I wire a scalar in, I get a single plot. If I wire in a 1D array, as we've done here, then I also get a single plot. A WDT, or a waveform data type, would give me a single plot. And if I wire in a 2D array, I'd also get a multiplot display. Or combine points with a bundle node. Let's try that. I'll bring this waveform chart back inside the loop. Control B. Wire this in here. I'm going to change our timing. Make the time perturbation faster. And the number of samples 10 times greater. Let's put another plot on the chart. I'll move this out of the way for now. And to mock up some meaningful data, I'll grab a sine function. Using quick drop, control spacebar, type in sine. And then I'll go grab from my numeric palette, my math constants, 2 pi. Multiply 2 pi by the iteration number. Divide it by the number of samples. To get this onto this chart, we saw that we can put a bundle function right here. So I'll use quick drop again. Click and select the wire, control spacebar, bundle, control I, and we insert it right there. Drag this down to get multiple inputs to the bundle function. Wire this in, and let's run it. Now we're still only displaying 10 points, but I'll come back here, back to zero, and there we go. We get a full 100-point cycle of our sine wave, and on the same display, we have that random number function, remembering that the random number function outputs between 0 and 1, whereas the sine function is obviously negative 1 to 1. Now how do we do this to the waveform graph? Same as before, pop up our context help, hover over the waveform graph, and we get a corresponding table. If we wire in a 1D array, we get a single plot, as we've already seen, a waveform data type, another single plot, a 2D array gives us a multiplot. So let's try that 2D array. Now how will I get a 2D array of both of these pieces of data? Well, I already have one array, and same method to go wire this to the border, get another array, and to make a 2D array now out of these two 1D arrays, we use a build array. Build array function, put it down, make two inputs, delete this wire, and combine these. Run it again. There we go. Exactly the same display. Incidentally, you probably noticed on the waveform chart, because I read it out loud, that a 2D array would also create a multiplot for the waveform chart. Can we just use this same 2D array coming out of here? Well, yes and no, because if I take it, grab it, and wire this 2D array to the waveform chart, run it again, then I get a weird display. If I put this at 1, I can see that, well, it's just really weird. What do you think is happening there? Really, it's just swapping columns for rows. So I can fix this by transposing that 2D array, going to the waveform chart. Quick drop again is my friend. Click on the wire, control spacebar, transpose 2D array, control I. There's my transpose function. I'll put this back to 99, run it, There we go. Actually, let's make that 100. Because we have 100 points. One little last step here. Now that we have two different plots, let's name them. I'll come over here, drag up my plot display here. I have different colors. I can change them, of course, if I like, including the style, the width, etc. I'll keep plot 0 the default, except I'll name it random signal, make plot 1 sine wave, and I can change this line width, something like that. A bunch of other options here for me as well. So far, we've essentially been doing the same thing to waveform charts and graphs, and explained how they're different, but haven't really discussed when one is better to use than the other. And really, that just comes down to the amount of data that you're receiving. If you're receiving a bunch of single scalar points, for instance, I have a software timed loop reading two thermocouples and a pressure transducer, and each time I pull that loop, I get a single value for each. Well, I'd use a waveform chart. That's easy. But if I'm reading from an oscilloscope, and each time I pull that oscilloscope, I get 1,000 points of data back, I'd probably want to use a waveform graph, because I probably won't care to see a history of those 1,000 data points. I just want to see the current 1,000 pieces of data coming from that oscilloscope, especially if I'm not using the graph to do any type of analysis, and it's just a qualitative display. Well, that finishes us up this time around. We still have more to talk about, like timing with waveform charts and graphs, and we'll get to those XY graphs. Don't worry.